Let folly praise that fancy loves. I praise and love that child whose heart no thought, whose tongue no word, whose hand no deed defiled. I praise him most, I love him best. All praise and love is his, while him I love, in him I live, and cannot live amiss. Love's sweetest mark, land's highest theme, man's most desired light, to love him life, to leave him death, to live in him delight. He mine by gift, I his by debt, thus each to other due. First friend he was, best friend he is, all time true. Though young yet wise, though small yet strong, though man yet God he is, as wise he knows, as strong he can, as God he loves to bless. His knowledge rules, his strength defends, his love is death or end of but a joyful spring. Oh, bonny prince, whose tender arms can force all foes to fly. Correct my faults, protect my life, direct me when I die. Correct my faults, protect my life, direct me when I die.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
By the Immaculate Conception, O Mary, make my body pure and my soul holy. My Mother, preserve me this night from mortal sin. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
By the Immaculate Conception, O Mary, make my body pure and my soul holy. My Mother, preserve me this night from mortal sin. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
By the Immaculate Conception, O Mary, make my body pure and my soul holy. My Mother, preserve me this night from mortal sin. Good afternoon. Today it's the 19th of March 2021, a Friday, and the Feast of Saint Joseph is commemoration of the Friday after Sunday Later. From today's Roman Martyrology. In Judea, the birthday of Saint Joseph, spouse of the Most Blessed Virgin Mary. Pope Pius IX, yielding to the desires and prayers of the whole Catholic world, declared him patron of the Universal Church. At Sorrento, the holy martyrs Quintus, Quintilla, Quartilla, Mark, and 9 others. And in other places, many other holy martyrs, confessors, and virgins. Today is Friday, and kept in honor of the Passion of our Lord, and tomorrow is Saturday, and kept in honor of the Blessed Virgin Mary. To so hearty welcome to the broadcasting of the Transalpine Redemptorist, the Saint of the Most Holy Redeemer, from the Holy Island of Papastronsay in the Diocese of Aberdeen in Scotland. May God bless you abundantly and with his blessing of divine and holy love. Our apologies for the streaming of yesterday, which did not even begin. For the rest, thank you for staying with us, despite of the bad internet connection at times, and to sure an enough fast internet connection on our isolated island, we use an internet connection over satellite. There are problems with the satellite service, which causes that the live stream broadcast is got short at times. We do what we can to solve this technical issue, but we cannot avoid sometimes getting cut short. If the broadcasting should be cut short today, please do come back tomorrow and we will try again. From the glories of Mary by our Holy Father Saint Alphonsus. Chapter 3, Our Hope, Section 1, Mary is the Hope of All. O God, how tender are the sentiments of confidence expressed by the enamored Saint Bonaventure towards Jesus, our most loving Redeemer, and Mary, our most loving Advocate. He says, whatever God foresees to be my lot, I know that he cannot refuse himself to anyone who loves him and seeks for him with his whole heart. I will embrace him with my love, and if he does not bless me, I will still cling to him so closely that he will be unable to go without me. If I can do nothing else, at least I will hide myself in his wounds, and taking up my dwelling there, it will be in himself alone that he will find me. And the saint concludes, if my Redeemer rejects me on account of my sins and drives me from his sacred feet, I will cast myself at those of his beloved mother Mary. And there I will remain prostrate until she has obtained my forgiveness. For this mother of mercy knows not and has never known how to do otherwise than compassionate the miserable and comply with the desires of the most destitute who fly to her for succor. And therefore, he says, if not by duty at least by compassion, she engaged her son to pardon me. Look down upon us then, let us exclaim in the words of Eutemius, look down upon us, O most compassionate mother, cast an eyes of mercy on us, for we are thy servants, and in thee we have placed all our confidence. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Today is Friday, and on this day, the reading is taken from the Passion of our Lord. By Holy Father Saint Alphonsus. Chapter 2, Jesus chose to suffer so much for us in order that we may understand the great love he has for us. Section 7. It is a pleasing thing to see a person beloved by some great man, and more so if the latter has the power of raising him to some great fortune. But how much more sweet and pleasing must it be to us to see ourselves beloved by God, who can raise us up to an eternity of happiness. Under the old law, men might have doubted whether God loved them with a tender love. But after having seen him shed his blood on an infamous gibbet and die for us, how can we doubt his loving us with infinite tenderness and affection? O my soul, behold now thy Jesus, hanging from the cross all covered with wounds. Behold how by these wounds he proves to thee the love of his enamored heart. The secrets of his heart are revealed through the wounds of his body, says Saint Bernard. My dearest Jesus, it does indeed afflict me to see thee dying with so dreadful sufferings upon an ignominious tree. But at the same time, I am greatly consoled and inflamed with love for thee, when I see by means of these wounds the love that thou bearest me. O heavenly service, what do you think of the love of my God, who loved me and delivered himself for me? So, dear soul, it's clear that we cannot doubt anymore on the tender love of God for us. Dear soul, you are cordially invited to unite yourself with us to pray in the here and now. The goal of the live streaming is further to communicate the teachings of the Catholic Church, including those of our Holy Father, Saint Alphonsus. The form of today, first hour, notices and Holy Rosary, and in the half hour after that, St. Patrick's Breastplate, the Exorcism, and after that, devotions. Today's devotions, the Novena prayer of the 30 days to the Blessed Virgin Mary, and after that, a meditation taken from the mystical City of God by Venerable Mary of Agreda about the Passion of our Lord. Dear soul, we will continue the story on St. Margaret of Cortona, today the second part. The day before yesterday, I told about the conversion of Margaret, how she wept under the fig tree, being now without any place to live in and that our Lord said to her that she had to go to Cortona, to the Friars Minor. By divine providence, Margaret encountered in Cortona two noble and virtuous ladies who had compassion with her and her son and brought her in contact with the Friars Minor. And I see that God, as a good and loving Father, is always ahead of us to bring assistance if we are in great need. But first, God lets us often a time alone, so that we see that we are nothing without His help, and so that we learn to trust in Him. Trust or confidence in God is absolutely of key value for the spiritual life if we want to advance. Margaret was accepted, and as the time was there, she received the holy habit with inexpressible joy. Our Lord reminded her of this precious gift. I have planted thee, my child, in the garden of my love. For thy blessed Francis, my beloved one, had nothing so much at heart as my love. He loved me to such a degree that no other has ever equaled him. And Margaret said, and wherefore, O Lord, dost thou call the order of Friars Minor the garden of love? Hast thou no other gardens wherein charity is so flourishing? No, replied Jesus, I find nowhere else in the world so beautiful a school of divine love. I have given this order to thee, and I have given thee the children of this order to instruct thee. Thou wilt find apostles amongst them to whom I shall give grace to understand the favors I am going to bestow on thee. See again how lovely God causes for Margaret, cares for St. Margaret, and so also he cares for each one of us. As soon as she entered the order, she went to live on a retired spot near the monastery of the Friars Minor. There she went to Holy Mass and heard the sermons of the friars. Our Lord had committed to them the care of her salvation. Margaret was wholly transformed by the love of God. She renounced all intercourse with creatures. She was entirely taken up with heavenly contemplation. She meditated on the sufferings of our Lord and began eagerly to seek to have a share in all his bitterness and consolations. Her only couch was the bare ground. Her pillow, a stone, or a piece of wood. Her food, a little bread and water, and a few raw herbs. She chastised her body with rough hair cloth, and she took the discipline to blood. The discipline, by the way, is the same as scourging oneself. In most monasteries, if not in all, it was the custom at that time to scourge oneself. In this way, one expiated one's past sins, one's own sins and those of the world. Of course, always united with the sufferings of our Lord. It might be less scary as one thinks, because one can determine self how much pain one wants to inflict on oneself. Now the love of God, of St. Margaret, went so far as to scourge herself until she bled. And probably more important reason of taking the discipline, is to bring one's flesh into subjection. For it is very difficult to control one's passions and inclinations. We are all weak and inclined to follow our passions and inclinations. To make it easier to control one's passions, one inflicts all kinds of penance to the body. The idea is to do so much penance that one has so much control that reason, enlightened by faith, can freely decide to do only what is good, what is the holy will of God. And thus we can easily avoid to sin. And that was what Margaret did, but obviously also to expiate all the penance she had to do after her sins had been forgiven. And further, she did so much of other kinds of penance out of love for our Lord. Her nights were spent almost without sleep in continual prayer and contemplation. The memory of the passion of her Savior and her own sins was like a two-edged sword, transpiercing her heart. She wept and bewailed her offenses with such intense and vehement sorrow that they seemed ready to expire from excess of grief. It is amazing to see how deep she was in sin, and now exactly the opposite. She does voluntarily penance for her many sins, but the sufferings attached to it is quite intense. A good example for us, because we all have our sins, and in the course of time we have heaped up quite a lot of sins to be expiated. The Bible says that even the righteous sin 7 times a day. That brings us already to thousands of sins in only 1 year. Therefore, our Mother the Church prescribes us to fast in Lent. Strictly speaking, nowadays only on Ash Wednesday and Good Friday, but know well that in case we do for the rest of the days in Lent no penance, we have still to do quite a lot of penance in purgatory, if we are saved, of course. And the suffering in purgatory is far beyond our imagination. So it is really a very good deal to do our penance on earth. It is really a great grace that we can expiate our sins on earth. Let us really profit by it. All saints did much penance, one more than the other. In the first centuries of Christianity, some saints in the desert ate only a few times a week. In comparison, how little is our penance when we fast. Let's do our best in the little time which rests us before Easter. The commandments are, in the first place, of course, important for our supernatural life, but very often they include a benefit for the body as well. The commandments not to do servile work on Sundays, for example, gives not only more time for the spiritual life, one has a bit time to read spiritual books and to pray and to go to church, but this Sunday commandment gives also rest for the body. The body simply needs to rest at regular times, otherwise it would collapse eventually from exhaustion. Ons God Vader, zet to befleet so. Dear children, many times you face tests of your faith and you do not trust. It makes every trial more difficult. The way to get through any trial with grace is to focus on my love for you. That is how my precious Son was able to face his crucifixion. No one will ever face a trial such as that. I urge you to keep things in perspective. You cannot live a courageous life in faith if you surrender to fear, always thinking the worst is about to happen. Unquote. Dear soul, it's much easier to bear the difficulties in life if we think on the great bliss of heaven. Even more easy if we realize the great love with which God offers us this great bliss in heaven. Let us therefore have heaven and the love of our Lord always before our mind. And God Father continues, I am helping you in any difficulty. If you do not believe in that, you do not know me and love me as you should. I know each trial and every victory each soul will face in the future. I am there waiting for you. Remember, everything comes with its own attendant grace. Depend on that. Unquote. So dear soul, let us then have trust in our Lord and ask for all the graces we need. The Holy Rosary will be in a few minutes.
Let folly praise that fancy loves. I praise and love that child whose heart no thought, whose tongue no word, whose hand no deed defiled. I praise him most, I love him best. Oh, praise and love is his, while him I love, in him I live, and cannot live amiss. Love's sweetest mark, man's highest theme, man's most desired life. Is Direct me when I die.